Hey Karin, so good to see you.
Hello Andrea.
Karin, you are now working in quality since 17 years and you have worked in different countries of the world and you were responsible for different technologies, so you are really ready to change. And that's so needed because we are living in a time with a lot of change in the technology area. And also the pandemic has forced us to change the way we work with our supply partners. So how do we keep up in quality with all these changes around us?
Yes. Thank you, Andrea. I like change. So that's a good start. But yes, the last 1.5 years of this pandemic has really challenged the way we work with things. And I've never been through a period with more change and more challenges that has completely changed the way we work.
Fully agree.
And our work is, of course, focused on the interaction with our supply chain partners, but it has also always been at large done at the suppliers. And now we haven't been able to do that. So we have been forced to find new ways to do our activities and to do our job even from a distance.
But how have we then done it?
Yes.
When you say from a distance, what does this actually mean?
It means that we have been doing our activities remotely using digital tools such as video to audit a new production line at the supplier, as an example. We are also using augmented reality glasses to both at the supplier location to audit as a supplier location, but also in our own facilities, sharing information with the supplier when they haven't been able to come to us.
But Karin, do you also think that there are risks being not physical on site at the supply partners?
Yes, of course it is. It's a video can never fully replace being on site with our everything we see and everything we experience when we are live at the supplier. What we have seen though is even though we have a lot of challenges with capacities and deliveries and so on, the quality level on our components have been kept on a high level even during this time. Then we have some activities that we can never fully be doing remotely. Corporate social responsibility audits is one thing that we have to do on site at the suppliers. Auditing a new production line or a new supplier not used to working with Volvo Groups is also something we need to do on site to be able to identify all the risks.
But all in all, Karin, it looks like that we managed this quite well.
Yeah.
Now, looking to the technology shift, which is coming with a super high speed, how do we develop and maintain the competences we need for these new technology areas?
Yes, it is a truly exciting time. We have all the new technologies, whether it's battery production for our electric trucks or it's the 3D printing of spare parts. We still have all the old technologies at the same time at record volumes, so we need to keep both in focus at the same time. We work with competence in two ways. First, when we recruit new engineers, we take a look at what areas we have the biggest need, both now but also in the years to come, and we try to find the best fit. But we also work with our current workforce, our current engineers, both with classic training but especially on the job, learning from our colleagues in other Volvo Group functions or from our supply chain partners. So we try to find the best competence there is and work together to learn.
So change to stay ahead is the name of the game, right, Karin?
Definitely.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you, Andrea.